Good day everyone. I welcome you all to this tutorial series on plumbing MEP design. In MEP industry, plumbing is the most complicated aspect of the design, likewise of the project. But to layman, we just assume is it not plumbing just to engage plumber. So I will be explaining explicitly on the system, and I will try to touch light all the important aspects. So to start with, we basically have four aspects in plumbing design. So we have the internal network, the external network, the swimming pool design, likewise the medical and fuel gases. But for engineers, I believe it would be easier to categorize plumbing system into the water distribution system and the drainage system. So you can just assume the medical gases out of the box for now. So to start with, the water distribution system is also the most complicated system in the plumbing system. But ordinarily, the major concern is always the pipe sizing, likewise the pipe types. Using myself as a case study, in my present organization, I work as an MEP engineer. But despite that, sometimes I do prefer just going to office. But the moment they start with the water, the piping layout for the internal or external network, I've always been present on site. But let me just make this video as a compendium for the entire series. So every project design always starts with the site layout. So here is the site layout for water distribution system. So you see, I indicated the pipe sizes 1.5 inches, 1 inches. So this is the major concern. Another thing is the pipe type. So I guess we are using Tiger pipe for this project. So we still have the storage system, which is also an important type. So that's why we do categorize the water distribution system into two. We have the domestic system and the municipal system. This project here now is a domestic system because I'm having my water supply, which is a borehole. So we'll be having our borehole. I guess it was somewhere around this place. So that was why it was connected to our GP tank. So it's an overhead tank. So, and sometimes it might be a municipal network that will be connecting to an external network. Let me find it. Okay, here is it. So for instance, this project is connected to an external network. Where is the site layer? Yeah, seems I've deleted this site layer. So sometimes it might be a municipal system that will be connected to an external layer. But in a nutshell, we have domestic and municipal system. So let's continue. Having gotten that, let's start with the legend. So for my project, it is my service or main pipe. So we have different types of pipes. So for the water supply, here is for the service main. Any pipes that are connected to the distribution network is called the service main. So we have the so that's the major concern in pipe layout. And likewise, I've explained in the fire suppression system, the fire hydrant. So it's using 2.5 inch. Okay, this one is even using 2 inch. So we still have the tank. Here is it. We have different types of system, which I will be elucidating. We also have pumps, in case we are using pump. We have different types of pump, booster pump, jet pump, etc. So let's just proceed to the internal network. Yeah, let's I forget the external network, we have different types of system. For this our project, I'm using a link or grid system. Sometimes it might be a tree system. Here is a tree system. So I'm only having a tap. We're just tapping from the main network. Tap. So I have different categories of system for the external network, which I will be illustrating. So let's proceed to the internal network now. I forget, for every plumbing design, the major consideration is the fixtures. So that's why my legend here is simply for about fixtures. So I have the sanitary fixtures, the pipe fixtures in my legend, so different types of pipe, cold water, the standard is blue, and you might design your pipes like this so that you have the CW, because we always have different types of pipes. So in case of complex project, for the hot water is red. Why we have for the drainage, we have about four basic type of pipes. So we have the soil pipe, which is the one that is connected to your WC. Any pipe that is connected to your WC is called the soil pipe. So we also have the waste pipe, which is anyone that is carrying the normal waste, maybe kitchen waste, or probably the normal toilet drain. So it's called the waste pipe. The standard is green, while for soil pipe is 30, some sort of close to this red, so that it can look like a soil or sand. So we also have the valve system, which is also a complex system I will be elucidating. So we have the valve pit, and I've explained this, the fire hydrant. So we have the drain system, we have different types of drain, we have the rainwater downspout, the normal toilet drain, we have a lot, which we'll also be discussing. The manhole or the chamber, so it requires empirical knowledge, which I will try to explain, and we have our sewage field. So let's proceed to where we're coming from, which is the internal network. So basically, we have cold water pipes and the hot water. So as an engineer, you will focus more on the fixtures positioning. And here is it, we have our internal network. So we have our valve pit, likewise the pipe sizing. Could observe, I could have specified the pipe sizing. So you need to develop a lot on it. Taking myself as a case study, I work for a real estate organization, but I've always been having offers on plumbing engineers. They need plumbing engineers, and despite I'm an electrical engineer, I've received almost 3 offers this year alone. So you need to work a lot on plumbing system, which I will be taking you through all the system unfailingly. So let's proceed to the other system, which is the drainage system. For the drainage system, here is the site layout. So we have different types of pipes, manhole. So here it basically requires empirical knowledge, what works and what doesn't work. So I will be explaining it. I also have a project here. Okay. Is another water supply project. So this is an internal network. How do you size your pipe, where to put your valve, where to put, etc. So for the drainage here, so here is an internal network. So how do you design your pipes? I'll be explaining a lot. Is an external network also. So in a nutshell, fire plumbing is the most complicated aspect in MEP system, which I will be transparent enough. I have a lot of calculation sheets here, So we have a lot of calculation. We do calculate a lot also, which I will be attaching most to this video. Likewise, I have most on my blogs. For instance, this is the water consumption calculation, water tank, septic tank, storm or water recirculation system, which is also a drainage system. We have the septic tank calculation. We don't oversize, we don't undersize. So storm water fixture unit, pumps calculation. So I have a lot of PDF I will be sharing soon. So these are my own personal PDFs too, which I will be attaching to this video. So sometimes I only get daunted. So that's why I have all these pictures. We have projects, we are selling 100 million. So it will be denigrating. And if clients wants to come to your project, they will have to retrospect. So maybe some of your projects have plumbing issues. And one funny thing about plumbing issues is that no matter how petite or minor it is, it will always show face in the project. And for the water distributions, the moment client doesn't have enough water, they will start complaining. Now that they'll be using booster pumps, and booster pumps doesn't even solve problem. So for every real estate companies, they are always in their need for experienced plumbing engineer. So it's not just ordinary plumbing. So here is also a calculator. So we have a lot to be working on for water supply. Water supply system is a complicated system. So I promise you guys that the series will be interesting. So you have a lot to work on, and I will be explaining explicitly on the system. So we have high-rise buildings considerations, the normal site considerations, the normal pipes considerations, swimming pool considerations. For swimming pool, let me give an instance. I went to one of the most prominent engineers here in Nigeria. So I went for I went for home automation. So it's disgusting. A swimming pool have to use 2 to 3 days before it refills itself. So although you might be wondering that, is it not just to refill water? One thing about plumbing system is that their correction is difficult. It's sort of a complicated issue. You can't just correct it on like electrical corrections or modification. So their modification is always so difficult. So we'll be discussing about flow rates, different types of fixtures, etc. So see you guys in the series. Don't forget to like and subscribe. So don't forget to like and subscribe, and probably keep your notification on. See you next class. Thank you.